Are you looking for a high wattage foldable solar panel with an MC4 connector? I've been slowly testing and upgrading my EcoFlow solar panels, looking for the right balance of portability and wattage. Does the EcoFlow 220W version 2 or Gen 2 solar panel meet what I was looking for? I'm Wanderer 001. Let's get into it. Starting things off, one of the things that I've always enjoyed about EcoFlow and their portable solar panels is one, the fact that you get a carrying case for the solar panel. Not only does it act as a protective layer against dust and water, but it makes it easier to take around with you. As you can see up here, we've got some handles with some synthetic leather on the top. This does open up and allow you to stash both the handles conveniently into one grabbable location. You do have a little EcoFlow branding on the front here, but the size of the case and solar panel when it's all closed up is 23 inches tall with a width of 24.4. And then if you want to call it depth, you have about 1 inch. It's not terrible as far as portability goes. One of the other things that I always enjoy about EcoFlow's cases are when you see the zipper here, this is actually a water and dust barrier because they interlock, as you can see here, making it more difficult for things to get in there, damaging your solar panel. Speaking of our case, one of the things that I don't particularly care for that is different from the Gen 1 to the Gen 2 is the Gen 1, this case was used as part of the standing mechanism for the solar panel, and it had a stiff insert allowing it to be used as part of that setup. But it also added an extra layer of protection. The Gen 2 models do not have that, and I kind of wish they did. Actually, on the Gen 1, I wish it had two of the stiff inserts in order to protect my solar panel. But I can see why they did that, because I can just kind of collapse this down when it's not in use. The overall carry weight of the solar panel is just shy of 16 pounds, so it is a little chunky, but you're getting a lot of solar panel in not a lot of space. Opening things up, you can see you actually have the legs, which we'll talk about a little later, but you can see you've got kind of a fabric backing on it, a little EcoFlow branding, and then your wattage here. Opening the front here, we can see the solar cell, which does have an IP rating of 68, which will give you good dust and water resistance. The Gen 2 also has right up here, show a little close-up of that, it actually is kind of like a solar marker, allowing you to better position this, and it's built in. EcoFlow does sell that as a separate add-on for some of the Gen 1s. The solar panel itself also has a rubberized coating. Actually, they describe it as an EF coating, which is very similar to Teflon, making this more dust and scratch and water resistant than something that does not have that. One other thing while talking about our solar cells for the Gen 2, the Generation 2 EcoFlow solar panels now use N-type TOP-CON monocrystalline silicon. And I know I'm going to say that horribly wrong. Compared to the previous solar cell, which was a PERC monocrystalline cell, the big difference is generally the TOP-CON, as I'll call it, offers higher efficiency and better performance in higher temperatures, while the PERC cells are generally known for their enhanced light absorption. So it's a trade-off. But when I open this up, we're going to talk about some other things to consider, because honestly, these have performed much better than I have expected. And sadly, filming this portion in the garage because, of course, it's raining out. In its open state, you are looking at 23 inches tall with a width across of 83.6 and then again a depth of 1 inch. Now, I want you to notice on the top here, here, and here, those are going to have the legs for the backing of this. So not every panel is supported by a leg, which I'll discuss a little more when we get around to the back. The solar panels themselves, as I mentioned, are the newer generation or a different generation solar cell than we had with the Generation 1. However, the solar conversion rate of the Gen 2 is up to 25%, as opposed to the 23% that you got from a Gen 1, meaning that the energy or the solar energy that comes into this when it's converted to usable electricity that you're sending into your power bank is 25% versus 23%. It seems like a very small amount, but that small amount actually adds up quite a bit. Over on the side here, we actually have our connection cables, and this does use a standard MC4 connector and does include the XT60 charging cables all within the solar panel package, which is great considering some solar panels don't actually ship with that. Coming around to the back of the panel, here we can see the actual legs and the holding mechanism for it, which really is just this elastic band right here. And the legs themselves are rather small, and they do feel like they could bend rather easily. And then I do have concerns as to the tensile strength of the elasticity. However, utilizing the included bands, which are on three of the four panel segments, you do have the ability to adjust this anywhere from 30 degrees to 60 degrees. I don't know why they skimped out and didn't add an extra leg for the center section there, because that was one of my problems I had with the Gen 1s, was that the wings were flapping because they weren't attached to anything. And with this, now you actually have an extra segment. With the Gen 1, you had a center and then two sides. This one, you actually have a set of four solar sections. And as you can see, it does sit up rather well, but you know, you get a breeze or an animal comes knocking against one of these or slightly moves it. You can see, I could move it. Well, there we go. It's drooping now and you're relying on the other two. It's okay, but you can see also how easy it is to just throw it back into place. It does mean you might have to babysit this a little more. Now, while it might be a rainy and gloomy day today, let me show you what this is actually made for, which is getting solar energy into a power bank in some brighter conditions.
Not an EcoFlow power bank, but late August, just lying it flat, I'm seeing 112, 115, and it's not even peak sun yet. Fairly sunny day though. Early September sun, should be right overhead. Just have the panels flat. It's at 173, not bad.
Doing this at solar noon, things are mostly sunny. Try and get the best bet I could. That shows you, no, because I'm in the way. Kind of where the dot is, doing this on my little river two, my little power station here. You can see 173. It did say 188 like a second ago, but it really depends on how intense the sunlight is. So, oh, here we go. Sun's coming out, getting brighter. There we go. Sun popped up. It said 180 there for a second. This is June, so not as bright as it could be, but not bad, all things considered.
With every product, even if it's a very good one, there are always cons, and there were some that I came up with for the EcoFlow 220W Gen 2 solar panel. And the first being was the legs, while they're okay, they're not super sturdy. They're very thin and spindly and would not hold up the solar panel even in what I would consider light breezes. So you would kind of have to tack those down. So on their own, not gonna be great. The legs are also held in place by elastic on the back. And over time, elastic generally degrades. So I'm not sure of the actual longevity of those particular leg holding mechanisms. Yes, I've had the solar panel for over a year, but generally I either throw it on my deck and lie it flat, or I have a well that I kind of lean it up against to get the optimal solar sun during the summertime. So for me, I've had a year of usage, but not a year of usage of the legs. One of the things that I have noticed is that the solar panel or the webbing in between does seem to get damaged a little more than I saw with the version 1. And I don't know if that's just the new top coat, if that's the different solar cell. It really shouldn't be the different solar cell, but just be aware you might have to be a little gentler with them than you were with the version 1s. And the last con that I can think of is that the case that it comes with, as I mentioned before, is not as protective as the Gen 1s, because the Gen 1 had the insert that you used as part of the setup process for it. But since this one has the built-in legs, you don't need it to have that protective casing. Honestly, what I end up doing is I kept the foam inserts that came with it as part of shipping, and I just placed those on the outside if you're looking for a little extra protection.
Unforeseen con of laying it down. I was surprised. The panel itself gets
pretty hot. So if you're doing it on grass, and if you look here, that's where I had it laid down. It got so hot that it kind of killed the grass. Keep that in mind. Maybe want to put something under it or lean it up if you can. If you're looking for a high wattage portable solar panel for home or on the go, I can recommend the ECOFLOW 220W Gen 2 or Version 2 solar panels. Even with the legs not being everything that I would have liked them to be, and the feeling that the panel itself is a little more prone to damage than the version one, I cannot deny that this has become my go-to solar panel for charging all of my solar generators, just because of the higher wattage and speed at which it charges. Because of that, I can strongly recommend it, especially if you can find it on sale. If this sounds like the portable solar panel you've been looking for, I will have a link where you can pick one up for yourself in the description area below. If you appreciate the time and effort that goes into making comprehensive videos like this, make sure to hit that like button to help other people find the video as well. If you like what I'm doing here and want to be notified of my next review, hit that subscribe button. Still not sure if this is the right portable solar panel for you? On screen now, you'll see two other reviews that I've done to help you make a more informed decision for yourself.